Welcome to Trump Teachings. It's been a long road, and we shall conclude with the long game, which I happen to think the Paladin represents fairly well. The Paladin being a class whose hero ability is one of the slowest in the game, since you have to use it, and then you get a guy who stays around, who doesn't do anything the turn it comes out, but going forward into the game, it's one of the most impactful ones since it has that repetitive one damage. It technically counts as a card on the board. It's one of the reasons why I like Paladin the most, because I do like steady, control-ish long games. And that's how this deck is built a bit, towards the control-ish late game. Once you get to level 2, you can replace these Wimpy Lights Justices with True Silver Champion. Pretty good weapon. Level 4, you can replace a Gnomish and a Senjin for 2 Consecration. Pretty good board control card. Level 8, get rid of a Dark Scale Healer for a Guardian of Kings. And level 10, remove the Gnomish Inventor and the Elven Archer for the Blessing of Kings. Alright, let's take this away.
Your soul shall be mine! I will fight with honor.
Alright, here's an excellent curve. 2, 3, 4 have the option of which ones. Can play out my early turns very mana efficiently. My opponent is a Warlock, and very similar to Fearless Tapping. And like I said when I was playing the Warlock deck, it is a goal to simply keep board control and then use that hero ability to gain advantage each turn. It's not that far, unlike this Paladin hero ability. He tapped turn 2. That might mean he is a handlock, or it just means he has a bad hand. One of those two. Oh, we're gonna be playing against a pretty serious constructed deck here, it seems. We'll see how we can do with this deck.
Don't mess with us.
It's not impossible to win with a basic deck against one of the stronger decks in the format, I consider. But the tools that many Paladins want will not quite be here. So I can either use True Silver Champion and fearlessly hit this giant. I will, because I'm going to need this 4 attack the next turn
for
as well.
Justice.
By using that instead of a Blessing of Kings, I save the Blessing of King. I mean, I get an additional 4 damage the next turn, which is going to possibly be necessary in order to deal with his second threat. I'll play the Frost of the Forelord, not an ideal time, but just to be mana efficient. Also, I'm going to hold this weapon, because, again, I need it to add the damage onto whatever he plays, whatever monster he plays. Here I'm able to kill this without losing anything. And I get to start adding in my hero ability advantage as well. He was able to gain some advantage early with his hero ability. That's the way Hemlock works. Just tap a bit, gain extra cards. But I can do that in the late game as well. And if I have several Silverhand recruits, that's still a threat to him. That Shadow Flame was a bit premature. Maybe he was afraid of my one guy. But here I get to start using my hero ability as well, and it's gonna be offering continuous small threats, which will always be annoying for him to deal with. And though his card is going to generally be better than my guy doesn't quite take this health resource. Huh. Here there's a few options. One is to play True Silver and attack it, but that's using a 4 attack weapon into that, and I don't really want to do that. I'm instead going to play the Senjin, and I'm going to make a guy. This isn't mana efficient. I could use the hammer to kill it, and I could do any number of things, but in order to go into the long game, I'm going to try to extend the amount of mana I can spend by making guys. This lets me go deeper and deeper into the game. I'll need to in order to combat all of these cards that he has. We're not going to finish this game anytime soon. I can deal with that giant, but it'll cost me a lot. I can also deal 11 damage to his face. 3 plus 4 plus 4 is 11. However, the Warlocks have a card called Lord Draxus, which restores their health to 15. So it's complicated. Still though, it may be best to put Blessing of Kings on this. This way, I put him in a bit of a dilemma. By playing Blessing of Kings, that'll force him, if he plays Lord Draxus, he needs to use this to kill this, and then he'll only have a 1 health Molten Giant, which I can Hammer of Wrath. If he doesn't do anything, then I simply finish him.
I must move quickly.
This seems to be a fine compromise. And I'll also play out a Boulder Fist Ogre to keep up the pressure. With so many cards in his hand, I do expect him to have some sort of solution here, be it to Shadow Flame again, or be it to play a big taunt. Any of those are possible and likely.
Shields up.
That's a pretty good answer. Oh boy. Well, good enough. If you enjoy long, drawn-out games where you incrementally gain an advantage and you try to control the board as well as you can, kind of similar to the Warrior Control deck, except this one is arguably even later since instead of relying on those heavy endgame legendaries, yes, you still have a few, oftentimes you can win the game by just repeated use of your hero ability. Then this is the deck for you! It's a control paladin deck. In the early game, you're trying to survive. Notably, you can use Wild Pyromancer and Equality to clear everything on the board for just 4 mana. You've got ways to survive, you've got taunts, and basically, you're trying to break even against them, and then you try to use the hero ability a lot in the late game. And they have to use cards to kill your hero ability, and at some point, they'll just run out of cards. And you'll outlast, and you'll beat them with the little guys.